Yeah, here we are. We're paying as taxpayers $615,000 at minimum a month to rent 205 rooms with an option to pay more to rent as many as 254 rooms at the Novotel. This is one of many temporary, you know, I put that in quotation marks, homeless places that we have created. And of course, with it has become, you know, with it has come syringes, all the things these people described in their neighborhood, the hotel itself, broken toilets, mattresses that are ripped up. Councillor Joe Cressy joins us. He's the Toronto Board of Health. He's with the Toronto Board of Health, City Councillor for Spadina, Fort York. Nice to have you.
Good to be here. Thanks, guys.
Let's just start off with what you've heard over the last couple of days. I mean, this has got to stand out to you as a real problem for this neighborhood.
Well, let me give you a bit of context in the city. So over the course of the pandemic, we've opened more than 40 additional facilities to provide physical distancing for people experiencing homelessness in our city. And so in some cases, these have been hotels that have been leased temporarily, like the Novotel Hotel on the Esplanade we're talking about. In other cases, it's been private rental buildings we've leased. And we've done that throughout the city because with this virus, we know, I mean, we tell people stay home. Well, if you don't have a home, it's very difficult to distance in a shelter. So that's why we've opened these facilities. Listen, we need to build communities that are both safe and livable for people who own and rent there, but also are equitable and taking care of the most vulnerable. And
okay, I asked you, you know, your thoughts on what those people were saying, and you gave me sort of the premise, and I do understand the premise as to why this is happening. But at the same time, we have to acknowledge that almost every single one of these hotels, at the very least, has come with the same type of problems. Syringes, people defecating in the streets, drugs, drug dealers. These are real concerns for people who pay taxes, who live in these neighborhoods, and not to mention the people who own this hotel that's being ripped apart.
Well, I guess there's two things here. I mean, the first is in the operation of facilities that we provide to take care of some of our most vulnerable, we need to ensure as a city that you have support services both on-site, inside these temporary shelter hotels, but also support services around them. So let me tell you very specifically in the case of 45 the Esplanade, at all times there are 12 full-time staff working inside the site, including housing workers, healthcare workers, but also there are outside the site and around it community safety teams working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, three community safety teams in the neighborhood, as well as security guards.
So, Councillor, if that's the case, what the hell happened?
Well, I think respectfully, the answer is we're dealing with people who are dealing with some really complex, challenging situations. In many cases, our homeless population, these are people who've fallen on hard times for a lot of different reasons. In some cases, it's substance use issues. In other cases, it's mental health issues. And so if for people in that type of acute, challenging situations, if the solution was simple, it would have been done already.
Yeah, but nobody's blaming.
Finish, thank you, is to provide those wraparound services, both inside a homeless shelter hotel to support people there, but also the services around to ensure that you are keeping the community safe and livable.
But you're not.
That's the hard work that we have to do.
But that's not happening. That's the problem. And listen, I'm not blaming the people that are in there. I understand that they've got addiction issues.
Nor the support workers are we blaming. We're just saying that this clearly doesn't work.
I think this plan is backwards, to be honest with you, and you've experimented with it in all sorts of neighborhoods across the city, and it doesn't work. The same problems keep repeating themselves.
Can I pose a question to you? What plan?
I'd like you to answer my question.
Certainly.
But you know what? I'll be fair, Councillor. You pose the question to me.
Yeah. So when you say the plan isn't working of providing wraparound supports in these areas, what plan would you propose?
I wouldn't, because I'm not a city councillor. That's your job. And your job is to assess the current plan that is not working and figure out how to make it better, or figure out what other plan you and the rest of your councillors can come up with that isn't going to cost us a fortune, because this is $600,000 a month for one hotel. And God knows, do you know how much this is going to cost at the end when we talk about how much money we're going to have to pay the Novotel back? Do you have any idea? Ballpark?
So as part of the contract includes ensuring that we replace any broken furniture.
How much is that going to cost?
Well, we'll see the accounting when it's all said and done. But listen,
it's probably going to be millions.
So if the simple bottom line, in a city as big as ours, in a city that has a significant issue with homelessness, 8,000 people who are homeless, in a city where we have a pandemic and a fundamental duty to protect those who are homeless, to ensure that we don't have virus spread go through the shelter system, but also to protect all of us by ensuring that there is safe physical distancing, I think that is a value and a cost well spent.
You think this plan is working?
Oh, until homelessness is not a sight on our streets, I'm not satisfied. And so,
I mean for the people in the neighborhood. What about them? So, like you've spent 7 minutes with us this afternoon, and you haven't once addressed their concerns.
So we have a community liaison committee that includes the local St. Lawrence Neighborhood Association, the Business Improvement Area, representatives from every building in the neighborhood, along with other key stakeholders like the daycare. We've had 6 meetings since March, and every single time as a local community coming together, we've sought to identify where are we doing well, where do we need to improve. So when it was clear we needed to expand and add community safety teams, we did. And so this is where I don't accept the premise that we can either have livable neighborhoods or neighborhoods where everybody can belong. I believe we have to continue to do both, and it's hard work. Is it easy? Of course not. We're dealing with people who are really struggling on the margins, and that's why we need to continue to expand services, the healthcare services.
Let me ask, I've only got 60 seconds.
Both.
I've only got 60 seconds left here, and I want to know, is the city covering off all the price of this, or has the federal government agreed to cover off some? And if so, how much has the federal government agreed to backstop this project?
Well, so this project is part of a more than 40 sites to provide safe physical distancing throughout the entire city. This is being funded by all 3 levels of government as part of our COVID response. And fundamentally, not only do we have to ensure that we're protecting people from COVID through safe physical distancing, we need to work to provide permanent housing through this model to end homelessness.
How much have the feds agreed to backstop this by? How much? What's the number?
So the total cost for our shelter support and housing program in the 2020 year was $200 million. I don't have the exact number at my fingertips of what the federal and provincial contribution was for that.
All right, Councillor, thank you.
You bet. All the best.
Thank you, Councillor.
City Councillor Joe Cressy. Sorry, Jay.
It's all right.
I did a lot of the talking there.
No, I mean, we didn't even get to ask if you enjoyed the air show.
Maybe that'll be for another time.
That will be for the next visit.